viewers, you're watching the Policy Times. Today we are at the 11th International Convention of ANMI, and today we have with us a very important person from the commodity and equity market. He is Narinder Wadhwa, the president of Commodity Participants Association of India. We would like to know from him what has been the changes and what has been the response of the commodity and the equity markets after the new budget presented by our financial minister.
See, although there is nothing for commodities market, we were pushing for rationalization of cost of transaction in India. With the introduction of CTT in 2013, our volumes in commodities markets have fallen by 60%. Earlier, they used to be 80,000 crore per day. Now it is at around 27,000 crore. We attribute majorly it to the cost of transaction. So our submission before the budgets were to rationalize the cost of transaction and reduce the CTT. Although it has not come, but they recognize this that the commodities markets are very elastic to the cost of transaction. We have again given our submission to the government, to the ministry, and we are quite hopeful that something positive will come out from this. So because we are talking about the buzzword is 5 trillion economy, and there are researches, there are reports that 40% of it will come from the commodities market. So we have to make ecosystem of commodities very robust, and what is lacking there, we have to address to that. And as an association, we gave our detailed submission for reducing the CTT.
So I would like to know from you that since the 40% of the market will be contributions from the commodity market, so what has been the steps which the market, commodity and equity market, will follow to contribute to the $5 trillion economy, and what are the things, what has been the response as a whole? I would like to know from you.
See, this 40% is of commodities market. Again, the capital formation is must. It will come from the capital market, equity market, and whatever is raised by the corporates will go to the commodities market, because ours is a commodity market, commodity industry, commodity economy basically. So it will come from commodities. So in our markets, major thrust is not on investment but hedging and liquidity. So these are the focus area of commodities market, and it has a very positive role to play for achieving the 5 trillion economy. So one purpose for creating these markets were that we will at some point of time we will relate spot market with the derivative market. So far it hasn't happened. Most of the players in the commodities market are financial players. So they are not corporate, they are not the hedgers, not the real users, not much basically. So we have to see that these players are there in the market. There are three P's, we say, for the growth of the commodities market. These are policy, products and the products basically. So all the elements, all P's are there. So we have policy initiative taken by the government. FMC has been merged with the SEBI, and the members are allowed to trade. Equity players are allowed to play in the commodities market. Then we have products, very new products are there. We are, indices are going to come in the commodities market also. We have option, we have gift city, where the, you know, new products will be there. Then SEBI has allowed new participants also, AIF3, mutual funds, they are not now allowed to participate in the commodities market. So all P's are there for the growth of the and the development of the commodities market, and I think it will contribute its role to the 5 trillion economy.
Right. Last but not the least, for the viewers, I would like to know, after the policies that has been recommended by the financial minister about the GST and about the tax redemptions, whatever the policies, what has been the purchasing power, you think, since you focus the maximum amount of the major sector, the commodities, the FMCGs and all include in all of them? So what has been the purchasing power, and how much you think the people now in Indians have that much of purchasing power for, you know, they will also buy the commodities to give the commodity market the returns that they are investing.
So this year budget, which is a policy direction, which is a policy direction of the government, the focus was to give people enough money to increase their purchasing power, basically. But what we have seen in last 1.5 years, there is a lack of demand. Overcapacities have been created. That is visible in the automobile sector. We had 45,000 crore worth of vehicles lying there, which are not, there's hardly any demand for the automobile. So government wanted some demand to pick up. They have tweaked the taxation, the initial part of it, and they are trying to strengthen and boost the rural economy, because the propensity to spend in rural or semi-rural economy, population is more than the middle class, basically. If you give them 100 rupee, the rural people or the middle class people spend 100 rupee, whereas, you know, if you give it to higher people, higher income group, they don't spend that much. So focus was to give it to the middle class, to the rural economy. Although they have succeeded by reducing the taxation, but again, much more was required from this budget to boost up the demand. So we are, and again, the finance minister has just said in the budget that it is not the final statement. As in the month of September, we have seen before the budget, they announced the reduction in the corporate tax. So we foresee that much more changes are going to come from the government side, so that demand is created in the economy.
Right. That's all. Thank you so much for your valuable insights and your valuable time. Keep watching.